Welcome back here to Cavaliers TV. We get it for the second half of the Twin Bell. It is the 10-8 Cavaliers against the 4-14 Edouard Montpetit Lynx. The Battle of South Shore separated by a 15-minute drive. There's no traffic. And now we have these two teams here. Edouard Montpetit snapping a 5-game losing streak, defeating Thetford 74-46. Champlain a 2-game winning streak, having won 2, lost 2, and now on a 2-game winning streak here. Sean Harper, this is a tricky game for the Cavaliers because they're 10-8. You're playing a wounded but hungry Lynx team who still have a morsel of a chance to get in the playoffs if they were to run the final four games with help.
Good evening, Mo. This is a big game. I won't say it's a Duke North Carolina game. It's a really close game here. Close, like you said, a 15-minute drive or less, but the Lynx are a good team. The second half of the season, they've been a tough out for a lot of teams. So Champlain, they don't watch out. They could lose this game here, Mo. And I like what the coach is doing on the other side. Coach Rick, right? He's doing a great job on their side. They're going to be a trouble in the future, but for this year, he's making them really competitive.
Lord, very familiar with these hallowed walls of Champlain, and here we are. Getting ready for Champlain. We'll be in their home greys with blue and white numeral trim. Edouard in their away blacks with red and white black numeral trim. And we get ready now for the tip-off. Augustin taking it against Ndomi. Could the Cavaliers get win number 11? It's something that has been very distant for them for quite a while. They're at 10 now, and win number 11 would be ever so sweet for them in their hopes of being the number 4 seed. And we're underway here. It is going to be Edouard on the first trip. Josh Lucas at the controls. Edouard scoring 65 points a game. Their offensive numbers are almost last or near last of the conference this year. And Thomas, the push, and he goes out of bounds as he was trying to get the ball away from Bouchard.
Yeah, that was pretty interesting. Like, the ball got deflected all there. Thomas was able to get the steal. I guess the ball will be back to Lucas right here, putting up the ball. There's a shot clock reset, I'm not even sure, but
24-second shot clock reset. So even though there wasn't a real clean possession to it, but now they put 15. So the referee is on point today with the shot clock.
Well, I think it's more Coach Dan Martin was on point. He reminded the refs that there was no reset there.
Oh, I know.
There shouldn't be a reset on that one. There was no possession, right?
Still a conversation right now with the referees. So we could put 10. 10 here. So get the ball into plus territory and see what happens. And here's Josh Lucas again. Back out it comes. Futsu for 3. Nylon. Big shot for him. And they're off and running at 8 points, 11 rebounds, and 33 missed in a loss to Champlain.
Futsu, that's a clean shot. Nobody on him. That's bad defense on Champlain there.
Thomas. Here is Bissett. Trying to work his way through, losing the handle. Back out to Robinson from the flats. Too much meat on that shot. Futsu back over it comes. And here come the links the other way. It is Pierre-Francois with it as he'll drop it back out to Lucas. So left corner goes. Bouchard trying to swing, whip around a pass intended for Auguste. And this goes back to the Cavaliers.
Yeah, you know, right now, the links, there's a good composition of Duke shape players. And how? Because Mr. Lolik is at Zodeshi, and he's built a great program over there. Got to give him his flowers.
Jean Robinson, here goes Ndomi back out to Bissett. Thomas, 3. Missing that rebound off of Lucas, off of Futsu. You decide who. It remains Champlain ball.
Like, sometimes the players are like, which one went off? Doesn't really matter. It's that Champlain ball right there.
It'll be Thomas. With it now is Thomas on the block, looking, finding Jean from the center arc. Back heel, rebounding is Futsu, and back over comes to Pierre-Francois.
Right now, Champlain's ice cold right here. Let's see what Francois can do with the ball here. Back to Lucas.
Yes, Edouard shooting 37% from the field this season, which is number 11. They were 3-1 when they hit 40% or better this season. And a 3. Back heel, rebound, snatching that ball is Augustin. A long three for Bouchard, and he hits that one. 25% from three-point range, and it's 6-0 lead for Edouard.
Bouchard lets the crowd know, hey, I got to hit that three. So I got ice veins right there. Big shot, up six. Champlain still ice cold.
They're 1 of 11 from three against Champlain in the first go-around. They've hit two already in the first 3 minutes. And that is a whistle. Thomas was hacked, and this will stop play with 7:55 left. And Tayshaun Thomas will go to the line. 10 points, 9 rebounds in 30 minutes against Edouard. Shooting 40% from the field, has 30 offensive rebounds this season.
Coach Martin brought in his players saying, hey, got to start covering some players here. We're giving too many offensive rebounds.
And the first attempt for Thomas is no good. Shooting this year from the line at 68%, scoring just about 13 points a game. Champlain scoring about 78 points per game. Four last five, they scored 77 points or more. And the second attempt now for the Cavaliers is good. 1 of 2, 6-1 lead. And it is now Edouard back in the front foot in possession. Bouchard. Here's Lucas. Kick out. Pierre-Francois trying to get around Jean. And that is going to be a whistle, and that will go against Edouard, who hit about 15 turnovers a game, which is rather clean in the league. They had 27 losses to Champlain back in November.
Yeah, that's way too much. Double their amount of turnovers they're supposed to have. Like you said, they're a clean team. Don't cause off. Forced turnover. Oof.
And Jean's pass, ill-advised. And here comes Lucas on the bike. Lucas, like a skier, dropping it back over. Augustin in for two. Timeout for Dan Martin. And they are off and flying from the blocks. 8-1 lead for Edouard over Champlain. Stay tuned here on Cavaliers TV. Lead for Edouard over the Cavaliers, a kamikaze start for them as they have come out there with a firebrand that has been burning the Cavaliers up by a score of 7.
And on Champlain's part, Coach Martin calling an early timeout. His team is really flat here. Maybe a little bit overconfident playing down to their competition.
And a whistle on Edouard. It looks like it'll be on Pierre-Francois. So Pierre-Francois call for the foul, and this will be the second team foul on the visitors from Edouard.
I haven't seen Coach Martin this animated at the beginning of a game in a while. Usually he's calm, collective on the bench, but he knows, he senses that his team is lethargic and flat right now.
Playing up and playing down to your competition, that is something that is ill-advised for any team out there. You want to play even. And right now they're down by 7. Thomas against Pierre-Francois. Kick out, Bissett, right corner pocket, short, rebound right over to the links, and here comes Pierre-Francois.
I think 4 of their 5 shots have been threes, and they've been awful. It could tell by the score, it's 1-8 right now.
Either way, Tayshaun.
Bouchard. Here is Augustin, and he is showing the regal quality. Twice led the team in blocks, had one against St. Foy, shooting 58% from the field this season.
Augustin has a good body on it. That's a push-off right there. Easy call.
Bissett's called, and now Shaari along with Ronnell Thomas about to come in, bringing in the heavy hitters for the Cavaliers as this five lacked the right recipe of success.
Oh, definitely. Like, so Coach Martin's seen that the team is flat. He's bringing in some fresh players. See that if they could bring in some energy to the game, because right now, they got 1 point in the first 3 minutes. It's not really good right now.
Lucas, whistle. And that is going to be a foul on Ronnell Thomas. 6:29 left in this first quarter play.
I think they're going to go into the zone. I think I heard Coach Martin saying they're going to go into the 23 right now. He seems like his team is so discombobulated right now, Mo.
And now they'll try to discombobulate the Lynx on offense. Pierre Francois. Schwery, quick hands, popped up in the air. Thomas, it remains Edouard Ball. Eight left on the shot clock. So it wasn't a clean possession either side.
Wasn't clean, and even that easy play there, that Thomas couldn't just grab the ball and bring it on the offensive side. It's really sloppy on Champlain's side right now.
Back out to Josh Lucas from the center arc. And that is a shot clock violation, and everyone knew it.
First good defensive possession for Champlain in a while. Or I think the first one for the game. So let's see if they could build on this. But the Lynx have come out super strong right now. We got Miguel coming, subbing in right now.
And no Miguel about to make his appearance in this game. First-year player. Are they going to bring him in now? Yes, they will. And Jack Robinson will go off. No subs for the Lynx with 6:09 left here in this first quarter play. Sean Oliver, Mo Khan on this Friday night. A lapse of concentration for the Cavaliers has resulted in a 9-point lead for the Lynx in this early going as we're south of 6. Jean uses his deltas against Pierre Francois. Kick out, extra pass. Thomas, 3. Off the range, rebound, and this will be Edouard Ball.
Champlain is just so off there. Thomas had a wide open shot there and couldn't hit the back, the side of the back, right? It's just rough right now for Champlain. Can they find their way? Can they? They might be 20 down if they don't find a way to get out of this funk right now.
Pierre Francois. Edouard will have nothing more to ruin the Cavaliers' playoff aspirations of a high seed. Back out, left corner. Side rim, rebound Thomas. Edouard 25% from 3, dead last in the league. And it is the Cavaliers back to Schwery using his size. Mount Lebanon. And he is in for 2. Schwery went 2-6 with 4 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 offensive rebounds against Edouard.
He's a microwave. He's coming in to score. He knows his time is limited, so he's coming to make things happen. And that was a nice little move on his part.
Time is limited. And here is Josh Lucas. Thomas on him. Finding into the teeth, Schwery will be called for the foul on Augustin, who has been an absolute menace, having a stormer of a start here for the Lynx.
Look at Augustin, look at that. Body's just like an Adonis. He's playing really hard, throwing his body inside there, playing really well there. And I think his sister is Patricia Augustin with the MVP on the ladies' side that's playing for Capital Courts, another high prospect on the ladies' side.
And the first attempt for Augustin, not so pristine. Only a 45% free throw shooter this year. Edouard shooting 60% from the line. No free throw attempts in one game. In fact, they were 5-6 in the first half against the Cavaliers. 11-28 against Vanier. So they're very twitchy when it comes to free throw shooting this season.
Oh, no, definitely. If you look at Coach Marchand's face, he has a lot of anguish on it. He's really worried right now. His team has come out so flat right now. They're just not crisp.
And that pass is off of Pierre Francois. This remains Champlain ball. 4:47 left here in this first quarter play. Slow moving first quarter of action here. Not much rhythm yet.
No, a lot of stop and go. Sloppy play, especially on the Champlain side. Lynx will hope that they stay in this fog for a while.
Bissette. Kick out. Thomas around Pierre Francois. With the Euro, and he is going to the line for 2 free throws. Tayshaun Thomas really showing the ability, the dynamism that you want from a player like him to really penetrate through the paint and get himself free throws.
Yeah, that was a great take by Tayshaun Thomas right there. Like, he slowed down, did a kind of like a harder move, decelerated, went up. Tough call for Augustin. Augustin's like, I'm walling up there.
And a missed free throw for him. He is now 1 for 3, I beg your pardon, from the line, shooting 68%. The Cavaliers went 4-7 in the first half. They shot 17-39 in the first half against Edouard. And now Robinson at the line, and he will make it 11-4 lead. And this has been definitely a slow burn for either side.
Oh, definitely. But more on the Champlain side, like I told you, Coach Martin is up. He's usually not up like this. He knows that his team is like teetering. They're really in molasses right now. They can't find their way out of this.
It's a fly stuck in amber right now. You can't get out of it. Lucas, back out. Pierre Francois, splash.
That's a second one for the game. Francois is like a very solid player.
They've had 10 games of 8-plus threes, went 10-33 against Stetford in the win last week. They're carrying that back. Schwere held up by Pierre-Francois, and here's a long pass for the touchdown. Lucas.
Pass what to Lucas back in the day when they won a provincial championship at Zurichi.
16-4 lead, south of 4. The Cavaliers have a big flat on their tire, and they are stuck on the highway going nowhere. Robinson, and again, the Cavaliers' inability to really get going right now. You can see the quizzical look right now from the staff members of Champlain.
Yeah, if they don't get out of there, they'll be lucky if they're not down by 20 in this quarter.
There's not been a well-mapped-out travel here plan for the Cavaliers, and they have not been able to break the resistance of Edouard in this first quarter play. Pierre-Francois. And this will be a whistle, and this will be a foul, and this is going to be Edouard Ball with 3:30 left.
This is a nightmare quarter for Coach Martin right now. He's trying to pull all the strings out, and he can't find a solution. There's nothing to be found here. His team is super flat right now.
Yeah, the matter now will be Francois Giraudot, and he is scoring about 8.5 points per game. Shot 50% from the field, had 17 points and 4 rebounds against the Cavaliers. To the end line it comes. Here, Francois for three. Nylon, a hat trick of threes, and they're up 19-4.
Francois on fire right now, Mo. He's just hitting good shots all over the place here. Three for him right now.
And the Edouard Montpetit Lynx really has silenced this sellout crowd at Champlain. Miguel, jab step, behind the back. Schwery from the center arc. Do you need it? Short. And this rim is looking like a keyhole in the door of a padded area of a bank machine.
Yeah, it's like a keyhole with a trying to bowl ball, trying to get into that keyhole. That's not going to happen. Like I said, like they're down 15 right now. They might get to a point where they're down so much that they may not be able to come back in this game mode.
Behind the back, here's Pierre-Francois. He's oozing with intent. Augustin, six left in the shot clock for three. Back rim, rebounded by Miguel, and here come the Cavaliers. Back out to Ronell Thomas. Open, Bessette, around one. Bessette, finding Schwery, can't finish. Second bite of the cherry is sweeter for Schwery.
That was going to be so deflated because that was a beautiful pass by Bessette to Schwery, but he was aggressive enough to come back and get his rebound and score that one there.
They trap, they break it. Back out it comes, and here is a chance, and this goes nowhere. And Lupetu in the game could not get that cleanly.
And so Danny, that pass just had just too much mustard on it. It's just like, you know, you're so close to the other play, close proximity. There's no reason to pass it so hard there. Just a nice little drop off like Bessette did to Schwery. That's an easy layup.
Yeah, in fact, there's two number ones. Jeremy Stanley no longer on the team. It's now Kevin Lupetu, who's now the new player for them. From the right corner, Robinson. And too much depth on that shot. He's airballed 2-3 so far this evening. And here's a long pass for the touchdown. And the finger roll was incomplete. As you look at Pierre-Francois looking like a quarterback out there. Miguel with the blistering ferocity, and he will go to the line for 2 free throws.
Wow,
it's Super Bowl weekend coming up.
Super Bowl weekend, Mo. We had said that we'd talk a little about it next game.
This is the next game. We are hyping it up.
Hyping it up. So who do you got, Mo?
I'll tell you in the fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter? All right, sounds good.
That's good save. You got to tease it. You got to keep people involved in the game, so we tease it. If I tell them now, they might turn it off and go watch the NBA game.
I hear you.
Or they might watch the Super Bowl Classics on the NFL Network for all we know.
That could be an option also.
And Miguel getting the second option to go through. No, Miguel played 60 minutes, had 4 points and 3 rebounds against Edouard Montpetit, shooting 40% of his field goals this year, 41 defensive rebounds. And they're down by 12 now.
Got a 1-2-2 press out here. Just trying to mix it up, trying to find their sea legs right now because Champlain is really out of sync.
Lupetu. Kick out, Pierre-Francois from the center arc. And he rims that one, rebounded by Noel Miguel. 1:18 left here in this first quarter play.
3-for-4, Champlain was just like, oh, finally he missed one.
And that is a missed chance for Bessette, who's not had a Champions-like game so far today.
Definitely not, and you could say that's the whole team, right? Really playing molasses. That was an unforced turnover right there.
Pierre-Francois Augustin whistle, and this will be a walk by him. That was too many steps on his process.
That's not on Augustin. That's really on Francois. You got to see, like, when you have your big man, you got to make sure that there's nobody in front of them, like, because it's not an easy pass. Not a lot of players can get the ball and now dribble it and try to get to the rim.
Curry in the game for the first time for the Lynx. It is now 1 minute left here in this quarter of play, and with it is Bissett. Watched by Marchand. Jean. Pierre-François on him, Robinson, Lupetto on him. 8 left on the shot clock. Thomas in orbit. This is going to be his time to shine now. Thomas up with the left. He's short. Rebound, well defended by Edouard. And here they come the other way, and they almost came into our first row.
Yes, almost.
And back out it comes, Lupetto. Left corner for Pierre-François. He's feeling it. And he is a fizz coming out of the bottle that they can't contain.
That beautiful pass by Lupetto to find what's the name, Francois in the quarter. He's 4-for-5 in the quarter, Mo. Got a 50, back to a 50-point lead right now.
And Jean is gone from almost back to where's no violation. And Carly Jean sends that ball out of play. And this is not what they expected from their big hitters of Champlain today.
They thought they were playing a little a puppy here, man. They got a tiger on their hands, and it's been a tough game. They haven't brought the same energy level as the Lynx have.
They've been very tigerish today, the Lynx. A Lynx is a smaller animal than a tiger, though.
Yes.
Bissett, and one pass too many, and with 2.2 left, this should be Edouard Ball.
Yep, no time.
So this is going to be a Hail Mary for the Lynx, and Lupetto will get it back. One pass too many. That shall not count. At the end of the first quarter, Edouard off and running, roaring with success. 22-7 lead. Stay tuned here on Cavaliers TV. Welcome back here to Cavaliers TV. Second quarter action about to begin, and looking at these stats here, Sean, not so pretty for the Cavaliers, but very nice for the Lynx.
Now you can see right there, 0-7 from threes for the Champlain Cavaliers. They got 7 points in the quarter. You get to a point where down 15, it can be really critical. Like, they got to bring this down by at least 10.
And Domi trying to wrangle his way through like a bull rider, and he will go to the line and Again, the top point getters, Thomas with two, Schreier with four, Thomas with two, and Dome with no points. Meanwhile, for the Lynx, Pierre Francois with nine, all three-pointers by him, and you have five from Augustin. He shot 8 of 14, 5 of 10 from three-point range. That is massive numbers.
That's massive numbers there, 22 to 7, 22 to 8 right now. Did he? Yeah, 22 to 8.
Well, they've been nerveless so far. Oof. They've been very nerveless so far, whereas the Cavaliers look nervous, look tense, look like this is a team that's 4-14 than being 10-8.
No, they look like a team that came into this game saying, hey, we have this game, we won the game without even coming on the court. And the Lynx are saying, hell no. Just don't think about our record. We're a good team here.
A three. That rims out, rebounded by the Cavaliers, missed by Kerr, and with it now is Thomas into the plus territory. Ja from the center arc. He misses a three, and Dome can't get to it. Robinson does. Reload. Bissett for three, and he can't hit it. Another reload for the Cavaliers, a new 14. They are now 0 of 9 from three-point range. Coming through, short. And recovered by Kerr, and away come the Lynx the other way. And that's the storyline right now. The Cavaliers cannot hit the three-point shot yet.
Can't hit the three-point shot, and plus they were unable to. Three possessions, no hoops. That's not good. You would think at least one for 33, but three possessions not getting the hoop.
Timeout call by Edouard Monpetit. 8:57 left in this first half. 22-98 for the visitors from Longue. Welcome back here to Cast TV. Sean Oliver, MoCon, 22-9 lead for the Lynx over the Cavaliers. They've led from jump to present, and it will be Edouard Ball on the end line. It will be Girardot who will inbound the ball with a cue of about seven, now making eight bodies on the lip of the blow. As referees now conversing, Francois Briette, who has officiated CEBL games, professional games.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, I remember seeing him.
I've seen him a few times. Going to get a warm reception from the Montreal Lions crowd.
I wonder why.
And with it now is Lucas with a warm reception to the rim. 24-9 lead for the visitors.
Nice take by Lucas there. Nice move by Lucas.
Thomas. Jean. Robinson post playing Dome. Very quiet so far for him. He's scoring about nearly 16 a game for the Cavaliers. Nothing yet. Bissett. And that might have been a loose pass or an errant pass, and that will be a travel on Domi, because Bissett, I think, was driving to the net, and he lost the handle.
He lost the handle, fortunate enough that Domi got the ball, but then he traveled. This is really at a level that you're really, it's not really, you're not really happy if you're in Champlain right now. They're just not playing well.
Beto is very happy on that, as he hits that jumper, played seven games, has one start. 20 offensive rebounds this year, 22 assists, and he's definitely been a spark plug for the Lynx. Thomas going up strong. He is short. And Dan Martin not happy right now. They're down by a score of 26-9.
And that Coach Martin was like hoping there was a foul there. Thomas felt like he had the finish. He just had to just missed it a little bit. Ooh.
Lepeto gliding. Augustin is hooked. And this will be a foul on one of the Cavaliers. Looks like Tayshaun Thomas. And now coming to the game will be Zevi Bastien in for the first time today for the Lynx. Ronald Thomas and Troy coming in.
This game could go either way. They might get blown out by 40, or this could be a miracle. The greatest comeback of Champlain history.
The great escape.
They're looking for the great escape right now. Coach Martin is looking for solutions here.
And right now the escape is nowhere near anything. You got 10. And the first attempt goes through in for Auguste. who so far today has had 6 points in his name.
And Nugget Stane is like one of the only players in this league that can match up physically with Ndome right now. You can see the shoulders. It's a big battle here.
Ndome is very good. Shirari going to get that ball. Gustain deflected that ball at play. 28-9 lead, and right now the Champlain crowd has no idea what hit them. A very sullen reaction so far.
Yeah,
so
no energy in the crowd, no energy from the players. It's tough right now.
Shirari. Get that to go through. He gets through right there. Champlain down by 17.
Shirari was the only one that's brought some energy right now on the team.
Lupetu from the center arc against Ronald Thomas. Back door on the end line. Thomas closing it back out to Lupetu. Jean on him. Open shot coming for Bastien. Augustin denied. Loose ball saved by the Lynx. And they go back and forth. And Domi with the stolen ball behind the back. And he lost it on his right ankle. And a 3-on-3 for Lupetu. Kick out, transition move for three. Bullseye! They hit that shot. Marchand is 24% from three this season. And he's led the team scoring four times at 26 against Sherbrooke. And Ndome, it feels like there's a hex on him so far because he cannot find the bottom of the rim in a 31-11 lead for the visitors from Longueuil.
That just epitomized the day for them. Ndome had a layup there, bounced it off his leg, and a three-point shot on the other end.
Jean can't get to it. Here is Lucas, 2-on-1. Funny, Augustin over Shirari, and Thomas with the rebound.
Good defense by Shirari right there to not give up that easy hoop.
Ndome going to the left. Ndome is in, and that almost rimmed out, and a sigh of relief for him. 31-13 lead.
Yeah, they're trying to get some energy down 18 right now. Defense!
Lupetu gliding. Open three, Bastien. Side rim, rebounded by Thomas. Bastien shooting 33% from three-point range this season. And here is Tayshaun Thomas. Champlain for the season, shooting 41% from the field. So far today, nowhere near that number. Jean, jab step jumper, is airmailed. Not what they want in this game.
Everything is just hard, difficult. Yes, some of it's from the Lynx, but some of it is definitely Champlain not playing well offensively.
Lupetu, rebounding Ndome. Could the Cavaliers go on a seam of points?
Coach Lowe can't be happy with that play. Like, they're playing so well. Don't need to force it right there, Lupetu.
Ooh, Thompson was called, and they will call foul on Augustin. That would be the second team foul on Edouard.
I'm looking at the coaches on the Champlain side, and they're like, this is a nightmare. They don't know what hit them. They're in a fog right now. They're trying to get out of it. Are they going to wake up for that bell there? It's like down 18 right now, Mo.
Well, they're stuck in quicksand right now. It's swamp land, and they can't get out of it with their convertible wheels. And right now, it would be Shirari, the inbounder on the end line with 5:42 left in this first half. Cavaliers out of favor. Edouard in favor. And this will be Champlain ball, 5:37 left, 11 left on the shot clock.
Yeah, that's even the pass. They're making it, the Lynx are playing great defense. They're making it so hard for Champlain to even do an entry pass. Like, it's going to be really hard for them to climb up this uphill battle here.
4-2 in the game. And Thomas diving. And this will be a foul against Edouard. And this will be against Thomas Bouchard.
Thomas Bouchard looks back at the ref incredulously. He goes, that's a 50-50 ball. You're calling that on me? You play so hard and you get a call like that, you're not happy about it.
Not very happy about that one. 5:32 left in this first half. You know who else is not happy? Champlain.
Champlain is more than not happy. They're just like disoriented what's going on right here.
Thomas Shirari in for two, 31-15 lead.
Shirari is hitting the microwave right now.
Defense! Defense! Defense!
Francois back out to Bastien. Here is Pierre Francois once more. Jean supports Shirari in backup mode. Josh Lucas trying to DB from Jean. That's a tough shot. That goes nowhere. Clean up short. Rebound Shirari. Champlain trying to get out of it. They do. Here's Ronald Thomas on the go. And Ndome on the left wing slowing it down. And Ndome thinking too much. And he got hit in the chops, it appears, with 4:52 left in this first half.
I don't, like, that referee will not make the call.
And that is a tech on Dan Martin.
Yep. Like, Coach Martin is trying to just trying to explain to them that the player just got hit on the face and there was no call.
Head coach Cavaliers.
And it's gone from bad to a migraine for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, but this one, you just got to say you're fighting for your players right now. The coach, the refs are missing some calls. You got to highlight it. If you don't say anything, nothing's going to happen. And ball doesn't lie. Ball doesn't lie, they're saying here. Rashawn Wallace, ball doesn't lie. They missed the free throw. Back to the balls, back to the Lynx.
Pierre Francois, he had 12 points, 10 rebounds in the win over the Cavaliers. He was 1 of 9 from 3-point range in that game, Sean. Today, he is 3 of 5 from 3-point range.
Yeah, he came ready to shoot.
And Ronald Thomas. And if you are a Cavalier supporter, in the eyeball view, they believe this is going nowhere near in their favor from the officials.
But there was a foul there. There's no doubt about it. There was a foul.
Thomas, he's got two personal fouls already. Trying to take off Lucas. Lucas gliding, drop pass, Bastien, reload for three, and that misses, and that is going to go out of bounds back over to the Cavaliers.
They got very fortunate there. Bastien is one of the better three-point shooters in the league, and they got fortunate that he was unable to hit that shot there. Can they bring it down by, the magical number is 10 for Champlain. As bad as they're playing right now, they're down by 16. If they could just bring it by 10 and regroup in the second half.
And Domi. Lucas, Adome dancing to the right from the left. And now 31-17 lead. Cavaliers on a 6-0 run.
You see Adome there. He's bringing some energy there. You see the old Adome that we know.
Pierre Francois. Champlain slowly waking up from their slumber. Don't want to be late for the bus. And that's what they've done so far in the first 14 minutes of this game. Bastien. Pierre Francois has got 4 left in the shot clock. He's the hot hand. And a charge. And this goes against Pierre Francois, the 14th foul on the Lynx. And coming back to the game will be Marchand along with Lavery.
Great defensive play there by Claudie Jean right there to cause the charge. Maybe that'll get them out of that slumper, get them out of their bed, and maybe try to get on a run here to try to bring it down by 10, that magical number 10 there.
31-17 lead. They're on a 6-0 run here. Could the Cavs get this into single digits before we hit halftime? Jean, here's Noah Miguel. Swing pass out, Thomas left corner, splash!
First three of the game for Champlain. Nice pass by Miguel Noah, and Thomas hit that three there.
Noah Miguel with the three, and now 11-point lead. The Cavaliers on a 9-0 run. Lavery. Coming through is Lapotu, left corner. Dynamite coming in from Marchand. Back up 14.
Good timing there by Marchand. Big shot from him there to bring it back up to 14.
Miguel. And one.
Schreri, great pass. Great pass from your big man for the that's like not even a high post. Great pass from the three-point line, and Miguel Noah to go to try to do a three-point play.
The Cavaliers, 16 dimes a game. They've had 5 games of 20-plus assists, only 5 against St. Paul last week. At the line, shooting 63% for the season, shot 76% against Sherbrooke. 9 games, shot 60% or less. And, Sean, if you look at the numbers right now, they're at that clip at 50%.
And Plin just can't hit another free throw there, but you can see that they're woken up from the slumber and they're ready to go right now.
They still have a little bit of cobwebs in their eyes, and here is Thomas, who doesn't have any cobwebs in his eyes. 15 off the shot clock. Here is Lepestu once again, watched by Jean, pick left, kick out three. That's a strong chance. Rebound, reload, recovered by Girardot, back out to Lucas. One pass too many, and this will be Edouard Ball, 2:47 left in this first half.
10 seconds left on the shot clock. You can see that the defensive energy has come back on the Champlain's part. Now can they get a stop? And like I said, that magical physiological number, they're trying to get, psychological number, they want to get down to 10.
Lepestu, Girardot, open from Riverside. That is off the glass. They'll play the advantage instead. A missed three from Marchand, and away comes Miguel. Jean into the paint, gets it back, and now Jean with 10 left in shot clock going towards his right with Marchand and him, help on the right. And that's well played by Lucas. Lucas now gets the bounce, breakaway, layup is converted. Josh Lucas, again, had a block against Stafford, a block against Hunsick, finding his offensive acumen right now.
And they were so unlucky that the ref was there and they hit the ref. Oh, another layup here.
Lucas, it is Groundhog's Day, no putback, no good. Utter chaos right now, saved by Edouard. And now they are in control for three. That's better than two. Timeout call by Dan Martin. Alex Marchand finding his flow. Four times that team is scoring. Has 46 field goals. And now they're up by 17. Stay tuned here on Cavaliers TV. Right now, Edouard is in dreamland with their lead of 39-22. And the Cavaliers are in a wash machine that's never stopping in the cool setting.
Well, Champlain had it down by 12. You look like they're trying to bring it. They're getting back the momentum. Now it's back up to 17. That's really deflating. So they got a minute 40 to try to bring it down by 10 here.
And Miguel... The GPS was not on properly, and that will be a turnover on the Cavaliers in this quarter.
Yes, they're down by 17. Champlain's down by 17, but they're playing with more aggressivity. And you can see they're playing with a little bit more passion also.
Lucas. Marchand, hot hand in the second quarter. Lucas back out to Girardot, I beg your pardon. Lucas on the left, and Chouari with the rebound. And now Lucas to Miguel. Miguel around Girardot, and he is fouled. So if there's one saving grace for the Cavaliers, it's stopping the clock, going to the line, but they have to hit the free throws.
Yeah, that's not a great possession. As a one-on-three, didn't really have an advantage. Got bailed out by the ref, but Coach Martin will take that.
Miguel at the line this season shooting 38%. And that will help the free throw percentage points.
Oh, definitely there.
Second attempt. And that's going to even help. Massive
big time.
Boost. Could the Cavs get this to 10 or less? 15-point lead for the Lynx. 1 minute left in this first half. Lepestu, kick out. Marchand finding Lepestu, swung around. Girardot, three. Too strong. Rebound. Thomas loses it to Lucas. Drop pass. And that is too strong. And a foul will be called. And Girardot will go to the line for two free throws.
Sure, we should not. It's like he gave him a hip check right there. He's trying to say my hands are up, but the ref wasn't fooled on that. There was a hip check there. He wasn't in the legal guarding position. In the cylinder, I would say.
Girardot had 13 against Stafford, shooting 40% this season. And you see why he is at the line shooting 73%, scoring about 8.5 points per game.
Girardot's sneaky good. I've watched a couple of games. He's crafty. He'll get you some hoops.
And he gets the second one, 41-24 lead for the Lynx. They are roaring right now, and they are in the pole position going to the halftime lead. Thomas backing up. Going towards his left, Thomas to the right, back to his left. Thomas trying to find help, nothing more than a dead end, and there's a whistle, and there's a foul, 29.7 left.
Yeah,
He manufactured a foul right there, Thomas. That was a great play by him. Now it wasn't a great play. I mean, like he was picked up this dribble, was able to get a foul there.
And now Thomas at the line again. He's not had a good day at the free throw line. He was 2 of 4 coming in. Robinson about to come back in for the Cavaliers. And this has been a near A-plus effort for Edouard and for this Lynx team in a rebuild mode, but this might help expedite the process in their whole
flow. Definitely. They've got a coach, Loic, great basketball mind. He's going to definitely get some recruits. The game is recruiting, and you got a good coach there. They're definitely going to be a force to reckon the years to come.
And it's going to go against Champlain, and back over to Edouard comes.
Now, so this is tough. There was a foul here. Now they get two shots.
And the team talk for the Cavaliers will be a lot different from the Lynx.
Oh, definitely. There might be some yelling, screaming in the Champlain locker room the way they're playing right now, trying
they're
to wake them
very
up.
Kind. Being very kind about that one.
I know. It's PG, right? So you gotta say that there's just gonna be some yelling.
Constructive criticism, I think, is the better term for you.
I think that's it. Yeah. Just some feedback.
Yeah, you know, you see something good, say something bad, say something good. And right now, the Cavaliers have not had many good things to say. Edouard has had plenty of good things to say. And Thomas will go back over. 20 seconds left. Shot clock will be off. Time out called by Edouard. Stay tuned. 20 seconds left in this first half. Welcome back here, 42-25 lead for Edouard over Champlain. It has been a complete A1 effort by them. They have definitely run right on the Cavaliers in this ball game. And now the Cavaliers have to be a second half show if they want to get back in this matchup.
Yeah, it's going to be one of those smash and grab. This is going to have to be a great escape by Champlain because they're down 17. They're not playing really well. And Lennox, the Lynx are playing with, they're oozing with confidence from the way they're playing, hitting their shots and playing.
Whoa. And Domi, could he finish off this? Nope. Gets a recovery. Robinson now, 15 left in the shot clock. Cavaliers will do anything now to get a chance to get this basket. 10 left on the game clock. Here's Jean. Back out to Robinson for three.
Coach Willick is not happy there. Like.
And at the end of the first half, the Cavaliers are in red ink, down by a score of 42-28. Can everyone hold on? Or Champlain make a run of it in the second half? Stay tuned here on Cavaliers TV.
15 is not bad.
Thank you.
Welcome back here to halftime. And for the Cavaliers, not what they wanted, down 42-28. And for the Lynx, a perfect start for them.
Yeah, they're 8 for 19 from threes. They're plus 6 on threes with Champlain. Champlain's 2 for 11. This game should be even up more. Like we said during the intermission, Coach Lowe calls a timeout, up 17. They lose the ball with 20 seconds left, and they hit a big three by Jack Robinson to bring it down 14. So it's a manageable lead. The goal right here is to bring it down to 10 at least in this quarter for Champlain.
Well, for Champlain, their starters so far, from my count, have accumulated only, you ready for this? 12 points amongst the five starters.
I think there's only one field goal. They've only made one field goal, the starters.
Well, Kari Jean-Nicolas Bissette, 0-5, no points yet. Meanwhile, for the Lynx, they have a plethora of players that have had scored points in this game here, led by Pierre-François with 9. And here are the Lynx. Josh Lucas back out to Marchand, and he's in for 2, and they extend the lead by 16.
Great start by, oof.
And a bad start by the Cavaliers.
I said oof. I could feel Coach Martin right there. They had gave up an easy layup, and now out of bounds on them from Robinson.
Lepestu back out it comes, to the right corner goes. And a little bamboozling right there, stolen by Robinson from the passing Pierre-François. He will go back to Cardi Jean, who's had a very up and down few weeks for the Cavaliers. Bissette 3. Too much on that one. Rebound to Lucas the other way. And Cardi Jean had 13 points and 5 rebounds. 0-4 from 3 against Edouard. Has made 65 field goals and 52 assists. And right there, the assist and finish to Augustin. And they're back up by 18.
I don't know if you noticed that, but during the halftime, Coach Lowick brought his players and said, hey, we could beat this team. We're better than them.
And one. Thomas trying to deny that moment as he made the science combined with the arts on that play.
Definitely. Thomas brought that. He's bringing the energy, but defensively, they're still out of sync here, Champlain. The only way for them to get back into this game, bring it down below 10, is to play better defense.
Thomas at the line. So far, 5 points, 3-6 from the free throw line, 3-7 from the free throw line. Robinson trying to get that ball back. Robinson dies in a tug of war, jump ball arrow, and it goes back to the Cavaliers.
Great for Robinson to get the 50-50 ball. Got the ball back for Champlain on that jump on the possession. It's a jump ball, like you said, to Champlain.
Bissette, the inbounder on the end line. Here is Tayshaun Thomas, watched by Josh Lucas. Bissette in the lower block, going left to right. Kick out, Robinson, right corner 3. Missing that one, I beg your pardon. And so far today, he's 1-4 from 3-point range.
I would have preferred that Bissette take that shot right there. He had a smaller play on him and kick it out for the 3.
Lucas. Back out, over to Marchand. Here is Lepetu, and he will now go through, stopping, looking, waiting, diving, 3 left, and this will be the other way.
That possession had no chance. Fumble, 3 seconds. They got lucky. They called a 3-second kill. It was more fortunate for them. Now they could set they could set their defensive link, so they got really fortunate there.
Now Carijan with it. As we approach 8 minutes left in this third quarter play, Jean trying to fend off Marchand. Back out to Ndome, jab step. Ndome strong and off the window, much better effort for him. Ndome was 2 of 4 in the first quarter half, now in 8 points.
Yeah, that's a great play by Ndome there.
Cavaliers trying to inch their way back down by 14. Open for the center arc. Right down the Riverside.
Yeah, they're
Lepestu on that one.
They're almost like 10 for 21 on the threes. It's going to be tough for Champlain to win if they don't hit enough threes here.
And that will not help on the three-point miss by Robinson. And here comes Lepestu again, going back and forth here, fizzing. And they have the offensive enterprise in full charge, up by 20, 52-32.
Yeah, they're 50% from three. 11 for 22 now from three, Mo. They're on fire.
They are blistering fire, breathing fire down the throats of the Cavaliers. Jean's 3, missing it. He's selling a donut. And Domi, and 1.
great take by the builder. Great pass by Thomas getting that off, that other rebound there. It's tough. It's tough from them. It's really hard to beat a team that's 11 for 22 on three, and you only hit two right now. That's plus 9 on threes there, Mo. That's 27 points different just on three-point shots.
And you think about the scoreline right now at 18. Could be a bigger difference for the Cavaliers had they defended three-point shot, because the Cavaliers this year, team shot 29% from three against the Cavaliers. Stafford made 19% this season against the Cavaliers.
And not hitting free throws is just, it's a killer for them right now. You're trying to get back into this game, but you got to get more possession, got to hit your free throws, got to be really opportunistic here now.
The irony is that Edouard was 2 of 23 from long range against the Cavaliers back in November. And today, a much different storyline.
More of the regression to the mean right now. So that game, they were 2 for 23. Right now, they're like 11 for 22. Oh, man, that's like that's 10 out of 46 or something, 36.
You look at the 46. Present moment more than the past when it comes down to it.
Yep, and right now they're shooting 50% from three. It's really hard, man. They've to get back in that game. Oh, we're set.
Shuere is going to go to the line for two.
Shuere, like, it's a good sub here. Shuere is like one of the players that came off the bench that brought a lot of energy. Things with Mel Thomas, and Thomas is coming into the game right now.
Yeah, Shuere actually led the team at halftime with 8 points.
Yeah, and he brought a lot of chills with the scoring, but also his activity. Great passes to him, and know how to get the backdoor layup from him. So Shuere is doing a good job for them, giving them a lot of energy.
And the free throw goes through. Shuere now 1 of 2 from the line. 9 points for the afternoon into the evening.
Not everything is lost right now. The goal is to bring it down by 10 by the time they hit the full court. Put some seeds of doubts in the Edouard Lake's mind.
Lepetu with it. Here's Lucas. And Domi on him. Pierre Francois from the three. Nylon going in for Marchand, who right now, you look at his numbers today, 4 or 5 from long range. Shuere in for the constellation two on that play.
Great play by Bissett, but the thing, you know, is that you're scoring two, they're scoring threes. That's an extra 1 point for you. So it's really hard to come back in a game. Like, you're like, oh, I'm back. You're still down by 18 right now. Until they shore up their defense on the three-pointer, there's no way they're going to come back in this game.
Lucas, too strong. Rebounded by Ndome. Here he comes. And he got that pick pocketed by Marchand. Back out to Pierre Francois. And now Pierre Francois will defer over to Lupetu as there's 5:24 left here in this third quarter play. And off the foot. And that will stop it. And this will go back over to the Lynx.
It's just one of those games where you just can't get it out of your way. It's one of the games, like, as a coach, you just, like, burn the tape. There's nothing to there's no value of taking a look at this game. Your team is so flat. They're playing in the last right now. Like, the great escape is going to be really difficult here, Mo.
Well, next week they go to Vanier. And home to Sherbrooke. And then they go to Dawson to end off the year. Edouard travel to Sherbrooke next Friday. Home to Outaouais. And they might get a chance here. Here is Pierre Francois with the bullseye.
Until we get the stats, I think they're 5 for 5 on their three, or 4 for 4 on their three in this quarter. It's like you're scoring threes, they're scoring twos. You're not going to win this game. It's really difficult.
And you're not going to win it with passes like that from Ndomi to Shuere. And the thing is, like in the NBA Jam game, that ball's on fire.
You know, he's eating up. Now he's on fire. Yeah, I hear you. Like, they came out gangbuster here. They didn't like how they ended the quarter, the Lynx, and they came back. And you saw Coach Rama, Lord, saying, hey, we can beat this team during the intermission. And, like, his team, he's emboldened his team to think, he's giving them that confidence to say, hey, Champlain's not a better team than us. Even though they have a better record than us, we're the better team right now. And that three ball just gives you energy. Everybody's feeling good. Everybody's hitting shots. You got your family in the crowd looking at you. You're feeling good, Mo.
Well, it doesn't rain on Champlain. It's pouring on them right now, and they have no answer stopping the barrage of threes from the Lynx. And that's going to go against the Lynx. Thomas about to come back in for Champlain.
One of those plays that the rest are trying to clean up those moving screens there. Like, he's doing a DOH there, dribble handoff and ran into the defensive player. So right there, there's a call.
58-37 lead, 4:38 left in this quarter. So Tom's coming back in along with Gilado. And for this Edouard team, looking to build the foundation pieces, and this will be a massive beam to lay down what they hope will be a mansion of a house of success in the coming years. Jean, he's not hit a basket yet. Miguel on the spin with another pirouette. Kick out Thomas. Looking, he will lace one up, and he can hit. Shuari does on the cleanup. Now down by 19.
Shuari is the only player that's brought some, Tim and Thomas, the only players that brought some energy to this game. They're down 19, Mo. Gotta get it here. Better 3-4 defense, but they're just on fire here.
From the near side, flats. Oh, he missed that one. That was close.
That was close. That was their first miss of the quarter at the three-point line.
And this go against Edouard with 3:59 left here in this quarter. Foul against on every, and this will be, in fact, the 15th foul on Edouard. None on the Cavaliers in this quarter.
And that's where Champlain's really fortunate right now. Coach Lowe can't be too happy. No fouls on his team. But that said, they haven't put in their position to get fouls. They're hitting a lot of threes, so he's okay. Don't call any fouls. We'll keep on hitting threes here. We're almost like 12 from 24 on threes right now.
Well, if that's the case, that's 36 points. Then that three-point effort alone would almost equal the number of points Champlain scored in this ballgame.
And you can never win a game if their team's going to score that many points on you.
No, you can't. No, you can't. And, you know, for Edouard, again, they've had 10 games of 8-plus threes. They won 10-33 against Thetford. And this is a team, if you go back to the first encounter with Champlain, as I said before, went 2 of 23 from three-point range.
And for Champlain, this game was so critical for them because they got some tough ones coming up. You got Vanier and Dawson.
Sherbrooke is a thorn in their side.
So they really wanted this game. They saw this game. Okay, it's a must win.
And it's not going to help when Lupetu hits that jumper. 60-41 lead. Edouard had 27 turnovers against the Cavaliers coming into this quarter. A little less than 10. Shuari can't finish on that one. Rebounded by the Lynx, and here they come. They are buzzing. They're fizzing. Intercepted by Miguel. Stay tuned for the Super Bowl picks in the fourth quarter. And here is Thomas. Jean. Shuari. Double team. They crash. They get the ball back. Frustration seeping through the Cavaliers' pores.
But that was a clear foul right there. That was a clear foul.
Lupetu whistle going the other way.
No, right now, down 19, trying to find some solutions right now. There's not much. Coach Martin is looking. I could have told from the beginning of the game, Coach Martin standing up throughout the whole game, knowing that his team is on the ropes right now. If they can't bring it down by 10, it's going to be really hard for them to come back from this game, especially when they're not shooting the three well and they're not hitting their free throws.
Yeah, Edouard trying to tighten another screw in this game here as they've been asking the questions of the Cavaliers in this matchup. Been a one-way traffic of threes for the Lynx. And for Cartier-Jean and Jean-Nicolas Bissette, no points combined.
That's a tough
Thomas. Miguel, six left on the shot clock. Shuari from the end line, yes.
Coach Rook is so mad. He knows his team was playing great defense. There should have been a travel call. There wasn't. Can this be a catalyst for the Champlain Cavaliers?
Lupetu, nope. Shuari, yes. Miguel on the go. 2:24 left. Could the Cavaliers get this inside 15 before half, before the break time of the third quarter?
15 is too much, Mo, man. Look, they need to bring this down by 10. I don't know. There's not enough time here, but still.
I thought I was being generous with that deficit. Here is Jean. He needs it. Back heel. And it is going to weigh and weigh until he gets his first field goal of the day.
It's been really tough for the whole team. Not only Cartier-Jean, but the whole team. They're not shooting. They haven't shot the three ball really well this game. And they haven't defended it well either.
Lovely move. Gennado is fouled by Tayshaun Thomas, and he will go to the line for two free throws.
I'm telling you, Gennado is a really sneaky player, crafty player. He got him off, froze Thomas, and was able to get to the rim, though.
You talk about this Edouard team. Last two games against Braybrook and Thetford, 4-7 combined from the free throw line.
Wow.
So they weren't attacking the rim as often. Today, at least 19 trips to the free throw line, make it 20. So they have definitely had a different course of plan here in terms of how they want to be. They want to put this Cavalier team to the sword with 1:46 left in this third quarter.
And for sure, like once you start hitting threes, it opens up everything else for your game. And they're able to, there's lanes, the spacing happens. And they're just getting to the rim now. Hopefully Bissett and Carter John can start scoring and help out their team right now. Down 19, Mo.
Well, they'll need a few more baskets from Bissett. Kick out. Left corner, jab step, jumper is no good for Jean. And it just feels like it's just getting worse and worse for him on this evening.
That's one of those games where nothing's going in on your team. Their best chance here is trying to get to the rim, but you can see Edouard's playing great defense.
Giano, and unfortunately for his size 12, is out of bounds. And Loke Rimba is not too happy about the position of his team.
Rimba was saying, saw something. Lepitu didn't see the same thing, so they were kind of out of whack coaching in the general there.
And Jean-Nicolas Bissett will bring it back up court. Champlain thirsty for some points. They have been dehydrated of anything in this matchup. Here's Schwery. Six left in the shot clock. Thomas in the swampland. He got caught traveling.
Yeah, that was a travel there. It's really tough for them right now. They're trying to. Coach Martin's trying every type of lineup. If you look at the plus minus on, if we have the plus minus stats right now for the starting five, it would be atrocious.
And now 51.6 left. Here come the Lynx. Up by 19, a comfortable margin. They will keep the playoff hopes alive, albeit they need massive amount of help to get in as a number 7 seed at this point in the season.
That's one game at a time, Mo. You build on every victory that you have there. They beat Thetford. Oof.
It is one game at a time with help required.
Definitely, help will definitely be required, but as Coach Lewick there, has to be ecstatic how his team is playing. He's not satisfied, the game's not done yet, but he has to be ecstatic how his team has shown up, and they've been knocking down those big threes there.
And now with 32.5 left, it will be Marchand, the inbounder. And he will give it back out. Coming strong, Giardo! Rejected by Ndome, and this will be a foul on Ndome.
Yeah, it's one of those games where in other games that would have been a clean block. This game, he just feels like he hit his arm just before he blocked the shot. And everything that Champlain's trying to do has been stunted by the three-point shot at the free throw line from Edouard.
And Edouard is on pace to score 70 points or more for the fifth time this season.
Yep, and it's definitely from... It's all fueled by their three-point shot and their great defense right now. They brought a lot of energy to this game. You can see they're playing together. You see that connectivity in that team there.
Bissett, here is Cardi Jean. Going to the left, back to the right. Bissett with 18 seconds left. Could he break the goose egg now on his points? And there is a whistle with 13.7 left.
Yeah.
And there'll be a foul on Edouard, on Girardeau.
It's tough. It's just tough right now. It's tough sledding for Champlain. They're trying a lot of different things here. They're lucky to get a foul right there because that pass wasn't getting to Ndome from Bissett.
And Bissett now at the line. And there he goes. He gets his first point of the day. He had 9 points, 5 rebounds in 32 minutes against Edouard, shooting 40%. This year has made 24 threes this season. And they'll need about 4 or 5 threes from him if they do come back in this matchup.
Yes.
11 seconds left in this quarter. Back out of Cubs. 6 seconds left. Lepetu. Nakshaw. Oh, and that was close. At the end of three, Edouard about to pull off the biggest win of their season over their city rivals. Stay tuned here from St. Lambert, Quebec.
Welcome back here. Looking at these stats, not pretty for the Cavaliers, very pretty for Edouard. And here they come with a pretty start and almost a finish right there, courtesy of Fotso.
12 for 20. Look at the stats. Plus 10 on three-point shots for Edouard. They're 12 for 25. Well, contrast that with Champlain, 0-2 for 17. They're shooting almost 50% from the field there, Mo. It's tough. Look at that. Five for me, Alex Marchand. You got Angel Pierre-François. That's 4 for 6 from threes. It's tough. And you look at the starters on Champlain. Like, it's...
Yo, look at Marchand, 5 of 8 from three.
Yeah.
I mean, Marchand's 5 threes almost equal the points from the starting five from Champlain today.
It is, it's one of those games where you're like, burn the tape. Let's get to the next game. It's just tough here.
Jean finally getting the first 2 points of the day. 64-47 lead for the Cavaliers, for the Lynx.
Is this going to be the greatest comeback ever in Champlain's history?
For three. Jardon misses. Robson with the rebound. And now Bissett is going to go and push the pace. Thomas. And goes back to the way.
And it's just tough. Like, every possession is going to be so critical here, Mo. Like, they got to play such a great game to just to try to come back and win it. You can't have those lapses where your foot is out of bounds. You got to score. They have to almost score every possession here. They got to go 80% on the field goals right now in this quarter.
And now the Lynx Nation is watching right now. The flag football coach for Edouard, Tam Villebef, watching right now.
Oh, okay. Shout out to him.
Yeah. He's the Kyler Murray of football quarterbacks.
Okay, I get you.
And here's a nice pass from Kyler Murray in Lupesti, but unfortunately, Augusta State cannot finish it.
So you're saying he's a smaller QB?
Yeah, he's small.
He's small but quick.
Small, yes. Absolutely. Here is Thomas with it. Going up with the short, no good. Thomas clean up now, 6. 64-49 lead.
He's giving some energy. Like I said, they've got to score 8 out of 10 at 80% and play great defense.
And that is great defending right there. Thomas, less thinking, more attacking. And that is not how you attack. And they've had a lot of disconnect right now with the passing. Timeout called, 8:27 left. And we're sensing there's a bit of a momentum shift here for Champlain from St. Lambert's. Welcome back here. It is Sean Oliver. It is Mo Khan. It's our penultimate home game of the regular season campaign. We'll have one more on the 18th of February. Sherbrooke will be coming to town. And then we'll be hanging out for 3 days straight at the Provincials.
Definitely.
There'll be a lot of us.
Mo,
sorry
to interrupt you. The people, the crowd, the fans want to know, what are your Super Bowl picks, Mo?
Augustin with the pick right there to make it a 66-49 lead. I guess it's a good time to take it. I mean, we'll see what Tayshaun Thomas does here, and he has another air pass to Ndome. So I am leaning towards the Niners. Not a confirmation, it's a lean right now.
Niners?
A lean. It's not a confirmation I'm picking the Niners officially yet.
What do you like about the Niners that much?
I think, for them to overcome two deficits to win in the playoffs helps. They're less injured than the Chiefs are. I think that might be the difference maker in this football game. And here's Augustin. The difference maker could not come up with that play. Here he is in the second bite of the cherry. Back out to Marchand, new 14. Lucas. Pierre-François has been a difference maker from distance. 69-49 lead, 7:44 left.
Put a nail in the coffin there. I'm calling it right now. Champlain's done.
And this is going to be a charge. And this is going to be a devastating loss for the Cavaliers, who are now
going to have to chase number four with a trip to Vanier, home to Sherbrooke at Dawson.
It's gonna be really tough the next couple of games for them. This game, sort of, it's done. It's down 20. They're not hitting any threes. They're not getting any possessions.
Well, we can talk about the NFL preview here. Here's a long three from Marchand. He misses. Thomas the rebound, and here comes Bissett. 3-on-2 for the Cavaliers. Back out to Robinson. Trail pass to Jean. And another turnover for the Cavaliers. That is now number 20. They hit about 17 per game. They had 8 games of 20-plus turnovers. And that is your story for the evening. 3-point shots and the inability to finish off offensive possessions.
No doubt. And, well, for my picks, how can you go against Patrick Mahomes? I don't understand that.
Augustin is going against Patrick Mahomes with the N1. 71-49. It's not going against Mahomes. It's that there's less injuries on the Niner team than there is on the Chiefs team.
What injuries are we talking about on the Casey's?
Joe Tooney's out. You know, you think about the Rushhead who got the sack against Lamar Jackson. He's out. Willie Gay is coming back from injury, so he's not really fully football fit. There's a lot of underbelly injuries that the Chiefs have.
I agree with you. Let's see what Champlain could do here. A lot of energy.
Your pick, I see. Bissett trying to change the narrative. Can't do so. Jean off the ankle, and here come the Lynx. They are running right. They are fizzing, and here they come with the rejection from Jean on Lupetu. And it's been a full-blooded affair of dominance by the Lynx today.
And you can see they're oozing confidence. Players are smiling on the Lynx side. They're like, oh, we got these guys. We got them. Ballast South Shore. We the king of the South Shore right now. That's how they're feeling right now.
Yes, because they'll have, if they do hold on to the scoreline, they'll win this game and have the point differential. So, yes, they would win the King of the South Shore battle right now.
And plus, it's always who won the last game. We don't care what you did before, what you did last.
Yeah, so, no question about that right now. And they've had the pedigree today. They've been hunting in packs. Their tails have been up. And they have been absolutely sensational today.
And Coach Logan's hat inside, you can see. His exteriors right now, he's stoic, but inside he's just smiling, brimming with confidence. Say, hey, wait till I get some more talent. Wait till I tell coach them a big three.
Thomas with the three. He went 0-6 from the field, played 15 against Edouard. 23 offensive rebounds, and that's a three for him. So for Champlain, they'll have a week to consider and reconfigure the lineup. For Dan Martin, this, as you said, might be you burn the tape and forget about this game.
Yeah, no, you definitely got to forget about this one. And you got some big, big, heavy hitters. Like you said, even that Sherbrooke game is going to be very difficult for them.
And Sherbrooke has had Champlain's number since they came back to Division One.
Nice play by Miguel. Schroeder is the only one that brought energy tonight. I got to give it to him. He's brought energy, and Miguel also coming off the bench.
3 weeks from tonight will be day one of the Provincials. At least 3 weeks from today, isn't it?
Yeah, it feels like 3 weeks from now.
Yeah, I think so. So yeah, you're right.
We're tonight right now.
We'll be game number 5 of 5.
Yep.
You have some nice food over there, I see.
Yeah, Coach Germanis has left me some food that is darting.
I think Eduardo's been eyeing that plate for a little bit longer there, Eduardo. So.
Eduardo's chewing that gum like it's a Big Mac or
something.
Yeah,
he's starting to visualize that food as being his own chewing gum over there. And right now, the Lynx have been eating like kings today from the three-point range in this matchup.
They're just like, they feel like they're at a buffet right now. They're just shooting those three.
All they can eat.
And
they're staying past opening hours with this eating habit of theirs.
Definitely. They're getting fat on the Champlain's defense right now.
It is Mardi Gras in New Orleans.
Oh, it is.
And here is Jean for three. Missing the three. And Domé in for two. And at what point, with this game being what it is right now, still a faint hope for the Cavaliers down by 17.
As a competitor, you're always going to compete. As long as the Lynx keep on scoring a little bit, they're good to go. Plus 17, it's really hard. It'll be a colossal collapse on their part. And Coach Luke is smart enough for anything. He'll call a timeout to stop over any type of runs. He still has two more in his pocket.
Does Dan Martin put in the backups to kind of preserve this game with his starting key players?
They're not playing next week. They're not playing this week, so this ride these guys.
Lucas can't hit it. And a long pass to Dome for the touchdown. He's stripped by Lupetu. And back out to Pierre-Francois. Up to Marchand. Drop pass over Lupetu.
Lucas doesn't feel too good here. Like it's.
You know what's. What? You know what's too bad? They both have to play Sunday in St. Paul at 3 o'clock.
Ooh, that's a rough one, man. Not only the game, but 3 o'clock. The game finishes at 5. Super Bowl starting at around 6:30 something.
They're going to miss the game.
Well, they'll get a chance to watch Usher.
If they have Wi-Fi on the bus, maybe they could.
Definitely. This generation, technology, I won't say generation, with the technology now, big shot by Thomas.
Thomas with another three, and now it's down to a score of 70. It was a two-pointer, and there's an injured player as well. Lucas is limping right now on one knee, 75-58. And he is bleeding out there. Dr. Thomas with his diagnosis over there, and this will stop play. So they will have to take him off and get a little bit of repair done. And coming to the game is Girardot, and with 4:04 left.
At least it's, thankfully, it's just a cut. I thought it was like he had injured his knee, but just a cut there. So he's happy. Parents are happy. Coach Lurk is happy.
And here's Tayshaun Thomas, who hasn't been happy yet. And watched by Augustin. Back to Ronell Thomas.
And you can just tell, just on the benches, you can see Edouard's bench is just so happy, like they're just cheering for their teammates. And
they're about to win the gold medal. That's what it is, and that's what you want from a foundation building block. And here is Girardot, who's fouled by Choueri or Ronell Thomas. You pick your poison over there.
Yep.
3:32 left, and that's the thing. I mean, it takes so long to build. You know, Sean, Seja, any collegiate or school sport is about cycles. And now they're entering their early part of the cycle in year one under Coach Lil Greenbaugh and trying to build up towards maybe year three is when they would peak and be in that competition for a medal.
And it might be even faster than that, you know, with the transfers and all that. So, yes, we're saying by year three. But once he gets a good recruiting class and the smarts on Coach Loic, I'm not going to bet against him. He's ready to build something here. Like, Edouard's gone through some tough times and gone through a couple of coaches. Let's see what they can do with a recruiting class. And Coach Loic has Dureshe also, right? So he's building players down there. May they'll come down to Edouard.
Could be a feeder system for him.
Definitely.
Foul Auguste. Champlain, 5 team fouls. That's the first team foul on Edouard. Timeout called by Edouard Montpetit. They're on their way to win number 5. Stay tuned. Welcome back here, fully furnished Georgia Mouse, who had a nice meal before, and now Edouard making a meal of the Cavaliers today. 25-54 from the field, 13-29 from three-point range. Cavaliers 3-21 from three-point range. Thomas missing that jumper. They're 21-50, and they have four players at 11-plus points today. And Marchand going up, can't hit it. Rebound right over to Miguel. 3-on-2 for the Cavaliers. Down to Thomas, and he goes up. And one.
Man, Coach Moore can't be happy. His Marchand went up to the rim. Similar play, didn't get a call. This, the player here, Geraldo, was set. Felt like he picked the charge right on the torso and couldn't get the call.
Champlain, 23 turnovers. Biggest difference, as you said, three-point range. Like, you think about those three-point shots, 10 plus 10 for Edouard. Every other statistical number, aside from rebounding, which favors Champlain, has been almost identical tonight. Free throw shooting and rebounding, free throw shooting, turnovers, assists, and that will be Champlain ball.
Yeah, but the most important plot, there's a timeout here from Champlain.
Timeout call by the Cavaliers. 2:44 left. Edouard on their way to win number 5. They're up by 16. Welcome back here. Champlain down by a score of 76-60. Super Bowl eats. What do you have? What's your favorite food to eat on Super
usually
Bowl?
I go to a restaurant and try to, I won't say the name, but usually I try to get some ribs, some briskets. That might be my Super Bowl meal this weekend again. You yourself?
We have a Southern theme this year. Courtesy of my friend who's a caterer. We got, I don't eat meat, so this is for my buddies. I made the menu for them. They got ribs.
Yep.
They got boneless chicken tenders.
Yep.
They got beef sliders, but lasagna beef jerk chicken, jerk sliders.
Yep.
We got mac and cheese. We got coleslaw and dirty rice. We got Jamaican patties.
Dirty rice?
Yes.
Never heard of that.
Oh, I can send you a picture too. Yeah,
you
can
send me a picture.
I'll post the pictures on Instagram. Oh, at Mocha19 if you want to follow. But yeah, that's that. And we have pizzas as well.
How many are you?
We are going to be 10. And they're excited for the food. Excited for the food. I can bring Edouard down here. You know, they're going to be hungry, maybe full by the time they've eaten that food. But yeah.
Definitely. Oh, wow. That seems like, I wish I could get an invite, man. That food seems so tasty.
This is a 10-course meal over here, and don't worry if you clean up over there.
You guys better pace yourself, because that's a lot of food.
Well, I don't eat meat, so I'm good, man.
Yeah, I know you don't eat meat, but the other nine are going to be eating pretty well there.
Yeah,
so what are you going to be eating?
I'll have the mac and cheese. There'll be other options, too. You know, I'm not too worried about it right now.
But what is going to be your default meal? What's your meal for the Super Bowl weekend here?
You know what? Super Bowl weekend, it's a bit of a trick, and there is the treat from Pierre Francois. Halloween might be 3 months ago, but they are tricking and treating today against the Cavaliers.
This might be his best game of the season. He's like 6-for-9, 6-for-9 from threes right now.
This is a signature win for the Lynx.
Oh, definitely.
As for my meal for Super Bowl weekend, the Super Bowl is really, you know, it's a lot of deluge of low-quality foods that we're all consuming for that weekend, for that Sunday.
Definitely, that Sunday. I can't.
So I got to go pick up the food from my buddy's house, Sean Brown, to pick up the catering. I'll bring it to my buddy Anthony's house. Yep. We got to lay it out, and there's pizzas as well. Like, it's going to be a lot of food.
Better pace yourself. The game only starts at 6:30-ish.
Yeah.
What are you guys going to watch? Is there any pre-games you guys going to watch prior to the Super Bowl?
NFL Blitz. He's got the arcade.
Okay.
Yeah, so maybe a little bit of NFL Blitz going on over there.
Usually there's a nice matinee football game.
Yeah.
There might be a hockey game, right? Usually there's a hockey
Canadians,
game.
Yeah, Canadians play this afternoon, tomorrow afternoon, and Sunday afternoon. Okay. So we'll see how this plays out.
1:12 left in the game here.
And for Lupetu, can't finish that one. Rebound, and Troy gets it back. 1:04 left. Long ball ahead to Ronell Thomas. And Thomas in for the two. And too little, too late. That's the conclusion of this game here. Champlain now on an 8-3 run.
I was going to say 14 points loss, but In reality, Champlain was never in this game. They lost the game in the first quarter, and now the target they were at the beginning.
Well, you called it. At 10-1, it was over.
Yeah, it was tough.
It didn't look like they were ready to play, and they had a big flat on their tire.
And Coach Martin Soddy, he sensed it right away. He was upstairs. He was up from his bench. He knew right away his team was super flat.
And you know who was super flat? Edouard.
Yes.
And they played well. They deserve full credit for this win. They know it. Now they're going to hold off the Dogs and kill off the seconds. And they are going to be 5-14. They will need some help here. Champlain, in all likelihood, will be in the playoffs, but now they don't control their fate for the number four seed, and they are now looking at either 5, 6, or maybe 7 if it doesn't fall their way.
It's that dramatical losing this game. It was a key game that they needed to win. Coach Martin's not going to sleep well tonight, but Coach Lewick is going to definitely be. He's going to be stoic right now, saying, "Hey, we won a game," but he knows inside he's building something for the future.
A massive win for the Lynx. And now they can roar as the Kings of South Shore on this calendar year. But the question is, can they get back here in 3 weeks' time to be a part of the Provincials? We'll only find out in a fortnight's time. Massive win for Champlain, for Edouard Champlain. Your thoughts here, Sean, to wrap it up.
Well, it's how you start a game. If you're down too much, you're never going to be able to come back. They were down like 12, 14 points. It's really difficult for them. And plus the three-point game, like they went 14 for at least 26. 14 for 30, almost 50% from threes. It's almost impossible to lose. 14 for 32, my bad. And Champlain will hit 3 for 21. That's a plus 11 on threes, 33 points. It's extremely difficult to beat a team when they're plus 11 on threes on you.
The Champlain 75, 23 points tonight. So it's a very tough game there, but nonetheless, those two that happen. Champlain goes to Vanier next Friday. I'll be there calling that game for Vanier. And we'll see you for the 18th, Sean.
Yes.
Super. So enjoy Champlain. Super Bowl weekend. Big win for the Cavaliers women's team. And a loss that will be detrimental for the Cavaliers. Could the Lynx now get themselves back in the playoff race? They get win number 5. We'll find out. This race is getting exciting and more intriguing by the second. We'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.